Welcome to another video here. What do we got? I wanted to give you guys an update here on the e-commerce website. I did some few updates on the application, so I wanted to share with you guys. And so let's do it. Let's make it happen. So this is the home page. Let's go ahead and log into the application. So the application, you can, this is the items that I got. You can go ahead, add it to the cart. So it's going to ask you to log in. So I'm going to go ahead and log in as a customer. So let me go ahead and log in as a customer. So see, now I'm logged in as a customer. It says customer. So I'm going to go ahead and add this to the cart. So see, you see the item. I'm going to go ahead and add up the second item to the cart. So now I got two items. So I'm going to go ahead and add up another one. Go ahead and add up. So now I have three items. So I'm going to go ahead and check out. So see, I have three items here. So I can choose to continue shopping, or I can do the summary. And because I'm already registered there, so it shows the address, it shows the quantity. So then I could go ahead and this, and it gives you estimate time when you're going to be getting the product. So then I can go ahead and place. So this application can be optimized to whatever you want. If you want to sell websites, if you want to sell clothes, whatever you want, you can adjust the CSS if you like. If you don't like my CSS, if you guys want to change it, whatever you guys want to do, you guys are welcome to do that. But I'm gonna, at the end of the video, I will go ahead and after I demo the website, I will share the GitHub so that way you guys can get the code from there. All right, so I can go ahead and place the order, and this is going to connect to my Stripe. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if it's gonna be able to connect to the Stripe. So let me go ahead and log into my Stripe account. All right, guys. So what you guys gonna have to do is create an account here on Stripe. See, this is, I'm logged into my dashboard here. And then I did use, in the past, I have used this here for testing here. So what I'm going to do here, I'm actually going to go ahead and copy these numbers here. This is just for testing purpose. So you can actually go here to documents here, stripe.com testing. So I'm going to go ahead and go into here. I'm going to use an email. I'm going to use my real email. So it's going to be martindebs 82. Well, okay, this right here. Not 82. It's 2024. That's the one. Martindebs 2024. So I'm going to go ahead and put a credit card number right there. And what else it says? Expiration date. Use a future number. Future date. So I'm going to go ahead and put in, 12/34. The security code, I'm going to put in, what is this? I'm going to make sure it goes through. So I'm going to go ahead and put in, 567. I can actually use, I'm going to try pins 567. And I'm going to put down Martin and United States. And I'm going to put down 338. Actually, no, the Orlando zip code should be 33837, I think it is, or 33. So I'm going to go ahead and hit pay. So if everything goes through, your credit card has money, so everything should be back to normal. So then it's going to be sent back to the home page here. It says order placed successfully. It says the order number is, this is your number. This is, you want to save it for your record. So that's pretty much it. So now I can go back to my dashboard inside Stripe, and I'm gonna go ahead and make sure the payment went through. So let me take a look at the date. So here what I got is shows. Let me go ahead and refresh it. So right now it was showing eight items. So now I'm gonna go ahead. It should be able to see one more there. So it's showing number nine. So it went through. So now, see, this is the one, and that is the email there that I put in, and it shows the day. So, you know, so, and if you want a refund, so yeah, so that's pretty much that's the application. So that's for the customer side. So now let me go ahead and log out. I'm gonna go ahead and log in as the admin panel. So let me go ahead and log in. Oh, I also wanted to show you something too. So see, it says my email, and it actually verify, make sure that you fill up the blanks. So I'm gonna go ahead and log in. I might use this one here. I'm gonna go ahead and type in the password. Let me go ahead and log in. Uh-oh, wrong. Okay, hold on. Let me see. Let me try the other one. Let me try this password. Let me go ahead and log in. Let me double check the password real fast. Make sure I did the right one. All right, guys. So I was able to log in. Oh my goodness. I was like, man, I can't believe I can't remember the password. So I was able to log in. So I'm in the dashboard here. Let me see. I have messages. I have dashboard, you know, like that. You can check the post. This is on the admin, you know, on the admin side. This is the for the post. That's actually there. I have the products. I can actually see the products. They were there. I gotta fix it. Think I gotta fix that. Let me see. Then I got categories. I got display there. So also, I was gonna see what else I got. Okay, so then I can log out. It's gonna send me back to the home page, and I was gonna show you guys on the register. So here you can actually register and see, you know, you create that, you can select if you want to create a customer, employee, company, admin. You can customize it to whatever you please. But you know, so this is the demo here. So now that we know it's working, I know it's working for sure. So this is the application. So now I am going to show you guys the code. So this is here, it's connected to my SQL. So all the stuff you see here, I have two areas here, one for the admin, one is for the customer, which is the UI. And inside there, I have the controllers for the home controller, then my messages for the posts and the products. And then also I have a folder here for the APIs. So this is for the customer side. Then I have the admin panel. The admin panel, I have some controllers that I created, one category, company, dashboard, messages, post controller. So all of that. So, and you can add up more to it. And then I got some views where I separated the views for that. So it's well organized in the application. You know, it can be you can add up more features to it. So I'm working on that. So I did create let me see. So I did notice my program CS was kind of getting a little bit crowded. So let me show you guys. So here I may end up making it a little lighter. So I end up creating a separate folder for my services, which is over here. So I create a folder that says extension, and here I end up separating that. So I create aesthetic file here, aesthetic, I'm sorry, aesthetic class application service extension. So here I have all my services, one for the Stripe, for the Razor pages, for the controllers. Then I end up separating to my end up creating repository folder. So I end up creating interfaces, so which is right here. I end up creating the interfaces, and I end up injecting that over here inside my services. So, and I also am using unit of work, and I'm injecting that into the controller, inside the controller here. So let me show you guys. Let me show you on the actual. So also, you know, the areas, I got the area for the admin. See, I'm using unit of work. It makes the controller a lot lighter. So, and let me see. So I have that inside my data, and this is the folder here. It says repository here. And I have one for the interfaces. Let me show you one. Let me show you an example here. So here is the interface. So that's the one. And I have another one, regular repository. So all of this will be available in my GitHub. So let's go here. Oh, before we get there, I want to show you guys. So I'm using SQLite, and this is for I'm developing the application. And when I'm gonna deploy, when it's ready to go, I'm gonna use SQL Server. So let me see here. Okay. So let me go ahead and connect this. So it's gonna connect. It's supposed to connect this. Oh, okay. It's not doing it. Okay, let me close all these pages. Let me close this. Okay. How it works, I have to go here. So there it is. So this is my database. So let me take a look at the users, which is over here. See, it tells me there's my name. It made up like little fake address because you have to put in an address. And I have one. See, I have one for the customer. So you got to put in. I have one for the categories, for the companies. This is for the comments if you want to make a comment inside the post. I got one for the messages, one for the orders. So see, the orders is there. It says pending approval. So this is for my post that I have. This is for the images. See, all the images are there. And this is one for the products. Let me see what else they got. We got one. So everything is getting saved inside of data. So it's very... It's fully responsive and also too fully responsive. And also this is the roles. So I have created four roles, one for the customer, one for the employee, one for the company, and one for the admin. So all of that will be available to you guys. So okay, now that I showing you everything about the application, so feel free to check it out. So all of that will be available here. I'm gonna go ahead and share the link to my GitHub. And you guys are free to be able to download it, whatever, clone the application, and you can add up more features. And yeah, so it's right here inside my GitHub. So, okay. So yeah, so this is the application. So I'll go ahead and share that with you guys. And if you have any questions, make sure you share. And then also now I want to take the opportunity to give a thanks to my new subscribers. All right. Give a thanks to my new subscribers. You guys are so kind and have subscribed to my channel. But if you haven't subscribed to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and make sure you watch my videos. Help the channel grow. And that motivates me to continue making videos for you guys. So all it takes is just that little hit the subscribe button right here. Just hit the subscribe button. Help the channel grow. Show the love, and I will return the love by making videos to you guys. All right, so that is going to be it for this video. Make sure I'm covering everything. Make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Actually, I forgot, guys, to tell you guys the extension and the VS Code. So what you guys want to do is you want to go here. Then you guys want to search for SQLite. And you're going to have to install this one, the SQLite Viewer, and also SQL Tools. So you're going to have to do that. And so that's going to help you. You know, you're going to be able to see your tables if you're using SQLite. You can use SQL Server if you like. I like using this one because I stay in the same. I actually stay in my inside my VS Code, so it's there. So for And also for testing purpose, if you're working with the APIs, Postman is a great one to use. But anyways, let's get back over here. I'm thinking about maybe making another video for like a coding challenge for the next video. So stay tuned and don't miss the videos. And I'll see you guys. Don't forget to check out my GitHub for the code. Which is right here. It says, look for one says online store, and you can have the whole, I did the update 5 days ago, so it's fully updated there. All you got to do is clone the application and you'll be good to go. All right, guys, stay tuned for more videos, keep coding, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care, guys. Peace and love, and keep coding.